we do indeed. Our fat contestant wants to hold a formal dinner party on a raft. Please welcome Melanie Mills. Our next contestant would like to ride a camel in Arabia. A big welcome tonight to Alison Radford. And our last contestant for next week wants to be a famous character actor. Say hi to Simone Wilson.
They do indeed.
Wonderful.
Have a good weekend.
You too. Okay, good luck in Adelaide on Sunday. Please take a seat, ladies, and welcome to our show. Well, maybe we should talk more with number one. Oh, you're right. She's up there. They're big, tall chairs. Tell us a bit more about your life.
A bit more? I love travelling, and I've just come back from far north Australia.
Good on you. Number two?
I'm an optical technician, and I enjoy cake decorating.
So what, do you make glasses, do you, or?
Yes, that's correct.
And so in your spare time, you like to make cakes?
Cakes and decorations, yes.
Mm. And number three?
I'm a student and I like painting people.
Painting people?
Painting portraits of people.
Well, fine, I understand. Big hand for these three ladies.
Recapture the atmosphere and the glory that was the Phillip Island Grand Prix last year. I think that trailer backing would be certainly one.
Trailer backing?
I like racing trailers while I'm backing them, yeah, certainly.
Oh, so you've got a race while you're backing trailer.
Full hammer each kid on the back.
What speeds would you get up to?
Oh, 60, 70.
And then one little slip, and then
it's all over, Tom. Like, you better 54 and you get the 50 and you try and back in the
pit. Yeah, right? No, pretty hard. It's pretty hard. Yeah. Okay, well, look, good luck to you with that ambition, and take a seat now, please, Rod.
No,
all the very, very best of luck to you tonight, too. Maybe these ladies will be in the trailer back.
Yeah, I'm sure they might be doing.
Rod, please ask your first question to contestant number one.
Right, contestant number one, what is the most embarrassing comment your father's ever said about you whilst you've had a boyfriend about?
Trailer backing with him.
Besides that, he said, take care of my little girl, she's the only one I have.
Yes, typical father statement, isn't it? Number two?
My father said he really likes big families.
My goodness. Number three, what is the most embarrassing comment your father ever made in front of your boyfriend?
When I first met, he said, hi son, how are you?
Oh. Rod.
Well, I think the big family tab sounds pretty good to me, actually. It's been a lot of fun. I mean, that'd be fun out there.
Fair enough, number two has got the first match with Rod. As you ask your next question to number two, please, Rod.
Right, number two, you were to have two of your possessions placed in the museum which would represent you. What would they be?
They'd be my French perfume collection and my blue fun-top car.
What sort of a car is your blue fun-top
car? It's a Mazda 121. It's got a fun-top that goes right back.
Oh, that's good. And your perfume collection. Number three.
That'd be my long black gloves and a Kraft cheese slice.
A Kraft cheese slice?
Yes.
In a time capsule?
Mm. In a museum.
Oh, in a museum, I beg your pardon. Number one.
My lingerie and my teddy bear.
Rod, well, that's certainly a hard one. I would like to say, probably lingerie, yes, why not?
No, I thought it was that hard, Rod. Last question to number three, please.
There you go, number three. Which of your features do you want to hand on to your children, don't want them to inherit?
My chubby cheeks.
You don't, yes, number...
Chubby cheeks.
She said chubby cheeks. Number one, which features do you hope that your children don't inherit?
My bust. Is that noticeable at the moment?
Number two.
My loud laugh.
Rod.
Number one, thanks.
Two matches for number one has Rod had, and one match for number two. Here's your 10 seconds, Rod. Rod, the trailer backer, what are you thinking?
Well, one is the word that I want to always try and encapsulate in anything that I do. And I won't do it tonight, fair to say.
Number two, this lady is an optical technician who enjoys floral cake decorating, Alison Radford. Number three is a student who likes painting. Please meet Melanie Milne. And number one is the lady in Jersey, and you will try and encapsulate number one into your melting one. This lady is a waitress, very interesting blue horse riding. She likes water skiing, she likes drawing. I think you'll like her a lot. Rod Carmichael, please meet Simone Wilson. This guy is crazy and you'll love him to death. And this weekend you're both off to Byron Bay!
That is fabulous, Roderick and Simone, and they have beautiful Byron Bay Beach Resort. You'll enjoy a relaxed back-to-nature environment. Your individual chalets are set on spacious park and woodland, fronting up to kilometers of stunning beachfront. You can try a hit of golf or tennis, play in the pool, or go horse riding along deserted sandy beaches. Then dine in style at the intimate beachside restaurant. You'll experience the lifestyle of the rich and famous on this wonderful weekend. Welcome to Byron Bay Beach Resort and Perfect Match.
Okay, Rod, you win with the odds. Two matches, Mr. Simone. What are your thoughts on this one?
Initially, what's that mean?
Now.
Oh, yeah, okay. Great.
Okay.
For sure.
Well, okay. Well, now, let's take a break, and then we'll return and find out, Rod, if you've chosen your perfect match in the moment. Roddy, back now with Rod and Simone, and you're up to Byron Bay for the weekend. If you're the perfect match, you'll take these prizes.
Rod and Simone, if you're the perfect match, you'll be really cooking because you'll have to see the Dykes Microwave Oven. This top-of-the-range oven features electronic touch controls, automatic time and temperature, cooking as well as auto-start function and auto-weight defrost. There's some great meals ahead, compliments of Samsung, and perfect match.
Well done, Rod, and all the very best to you. If you win that prize, to find out if Simone's your perfect match, here's Dexter.
Association of Tech and TV Australia. Bruce Mansfield will speak to you.